So hello again, everyone. I just thought I'd stop by really quickly for you guys. I picked up a couple of things the last month and a half or so ago, I think. So I just wanted to go ahead and make a really quick video. I guess you would consider this like a small little beauty haul, I guess. I did some shopping at Bed Bath & Beyond, at Bath & Body Works. I did a little bit of shopping at MAC. And a lot, the rest of it's actually drugstore products, so I'll go ahead and get right into that. I did stop at the MAC counter and purchased just two lipsticks this time. Two colors I picked up from MAC were some popular colors that are known here on YouTube. The one first one is called Please Me, and the other one is called Blankety. They look like that, and there you go, right there. Hello, okay. Let's see here. So this one, the first one I'm going to show you is called Please Me, and I'll swatch that for you. It's a beautiful nude color. I'm not sure if you're capturing that. I know the sun behind me is pretty bright. And this one's like a matte type of, well, semi-matte, I guess. Semi-matte, like nudish pink color. It looks really, really pretty on just about any skin tone. So that one's really nice. The other one I got was called Blankety, and everybody's familiar with this color. It's a beautiful nude color. It has more of like a earth tone brown type of color to it, and that one's called Blankety. And I'll swatch that one next to the other one, and it looks like that. It's going to be the more flesh tone color nude. It's right there. I picked up those two. I've been wanting to try them. In case you're wondering what I have on my lips today, it's kind of tough to see because the light outside is so bright. But this is a combination of colors. I actually have on, this one's called the Revlon Kissable Color Balm Stain. I know everybody's familiar with these. This one's in the color Cherish. It's a pretty type of, I guess, like pink iridescent type of color to it. I'm not sure if you're seeing that. There you go. And I'll swatch this next to it. I like to, actually with these kissable lip balms from Revlon, what I like to do is line my lips with these colors first, really, really good. And then I'll go over with like a similar kind of matching type of lipstick to go over it. Because I know that if the lipstick does wear off eventually, I know the lip balm will still stay there and it'll keep the color. So that's pretty cool. And I layered it with the NYX Round Lipstick Color in Paris, which looks like this. And it's a similar color to Cherish. And that one swatched next to, see right here, is the Revlon Lip Balm color stain. And then here's Paris. So pretty similar. I like to layer them on just like that. I also picked up a Revlon. Actually, this one's a, Oh, this one's a L'Oreal Paris lipstick. The Paris Nude. Paris Nude. And this one's a beautiful color. It's actually another nude color. This one carries more of like a peach undertone, it looks like. Looks like that. And swatch, it's going to look like that. So there you go right there. It's definitely different from the other nude colors I have, but almost similar. Not really quite. It's kind of hard to tell with the lighting, but it's definitely a lot different from the Blankety that I have over here. But what I picked up at the drugstore was one of the Wet n Wild blushes that they have. This one's called Mellow Wine. And it looks like that. This one's a beautiful, like, wine type of color. Really pretty on. What I've noticed with all the Wet n Wild blushes is they're super pigmented, as you can see. And they go really, really well. Like, this one right here, for instance, goes really well on, like, darker skin color. A Sally Hansen Extreme Wear nail color. And this one's in the color Coral Reef. This one's Coral Reef. I actually have this on my toes right now, and it looks like that. Revlon Star Attraction nail enamel. These are the nail polishes that you're seeing out on display right now. There are several colors, but they have like a magnet on top, which is kind of strange. But apparently, the nail polish is supposed to kind of give some type of, I don't know, some type of an illusion when you paint your nails and then you go over it with the magnet. But for some reason, I only bought this color because they're kind of pricey, but I wanted to give them a whirl first before I go ahead and start purchasing other colors. I really cannot tell a difference. I'll actually show you what it looks like on my nail, if you can kind of capture that. It doesn't do anything for my nail. I don't even know if I did it right or not, but it seemed to have did some type of an illusion to the nail itself whenever you did like one coat, and then you went ahead and kind of just did the magnet over it very slightly. It kind of did something weird, but then I was like, well, that's too light. So I went over with another coat and tried to do the same, and then it kind of just never did anything else. So, the color's very pretty, but I would not repurchase these because I really don't know how to use them.
These are the Revlon Nail Art Moon Candy nail polishes that are out on display right now.
I purchased three of them. I did see a girl on YouTube actually have this on her nails, and I thought they were super cool looking. I'm totally into
Revlon Nail Art Moon Candies,
and the first one I picked up was the Moon Dusk. And this one's the black on the bottom with the iridescent white or pearl sparkles, I guess. The other one I picked up is called Satellite, and this one's the, let's see here, they look like this. This one is the maroon base with the, I guess, like a corally orange type of iridescent top coat. And the one I have on my nails today, this one's called Galactic. And it looks like this. This one's the navy blue on the bottom with the light blue iridescent glitter on top. And I don't know if you can get a close-up of my nails, but they look like that. I do apologize. They are chipped at the tip for some reason, but I piled them on pretty heavily, so it's probably my fault. The clear coat reminds me of is during Easter, you know how they sell that iridescent like grass stuff that they put in the bottom of the baskets? This stuff reminds me of that. Exactly. It looks like it's the grass stuff that goes into these Easter baskets, and they chop that stuff up really fine or as fine as they can, and they pop it into like a clear base polish, and you have this effect. So kind of cool, I guess. Cool idea. I got my favorite all-time body lotion. This one's an Olay brand, and this one's in the Luscious Embrace. I'm almost out of my other body lotion like this, so I went ahead and picked up another one. I absolutely love this body lotion. Hydrate my body all day, and you can't go wrong whenever you have beautiful smelling soft skin. So there you go. And this smell right here smells amazing. I usually buy the body wash to go along with it too, just so I can have like double up on the scent. Ulta had a huge sale of 40% off all Revlon. Wait, no. Yeah, all Revlon, all NYX, and all Physician Formula, and all Almay products at Ulta. So, I purchased the cream blush from NYX. Let me get back on track. I went off on a bunny trail. But I purchased this color from NYX only because I ran out of my Glow Minerals cream blush. And it's very, very similar to this one. The one that I'm running out of is called Fig from Glow Minerals. It's a beautiful, like, how do you explain? It's like a type of orange peach color. It's super pretty. It has a really warm undertone. And I'm so mad that I'm already running out of it. I already hit pan, and I'm literally like brushing my whole brush into the sides of the corners just to get the rest of the product. But it's cream-based, so I did already try this on. The only thing I did not like about these is they're sticky. They're really sticky. It gives you a nice, pretty finish on your cheeks, but when you touch your skin, it's like super sticky. I really didn't like that about this, so that's why I went with one. I probably will not repurchase this as much as I love NYX, but I know the ones from Glow Minerals, when you put them on, they dry matte, but they still give you like a dewy finish, which is super cool, and it's mineralized, so it's good for your skin again. But I noticed that with those, they don't leave your skin feeling real sticky and tacky, but this one kind of did, so I really didn't like that about it. But anyhow, yeah, to each their own. The other thing I did purchase from Ulta, one Physician Formula product, and this is the little palette, the nude palette that they have. Looks like this. I've already opened it. Sorry, I got rid of the packaging. I'm super bad at that. I cannot save products for the life of me just to wait to do a video or haul video or whatever, because I get so antsy. I want to try the product as soon as I get home. I'm like that kid in the car trying to unwrap shit. Like I'm really doing that with my makeup. So I opened it. I used it the very next day, took it in my purse. Loved it. Loved the size. If you look at all the colors, it's like a strip of colors. Gorgeous. This reminds me of a miniature version of both Naked 1, Naked 2 palettes combined. I walked away from Ulta spending less than $10. I was super stoked. I was like, wow. Even my friend was like, I'm so proud of you, Sherry, for not spending more than
$50 at a time. I was like, I know, I'm proud of myself too. But anyhow, that's why I purchased it. It's a super compact T90, beautiful cover. It has like lace on it, beautiful and like pastel pink. But this is the Physician's Formula, the new palette. And I went ahead and got that only because I was eyeballing it at, I think at Target. And I didn't want to pay full price for it. And guess what? A day later, I got the little email from Ulta saying 40% off.
It's just, like, go figure. It's almost like the same goes. You're a day late, a dollar short. This was more like a day late and, wait, that didn't work out. I don't know what I was going with that. I did not know where I was going with that. I had it in mind, but then I just cannot remember it for the video, so sorry.
It's called Mahogany Teak Wood. Looks like this. Yep, smells like a man's cologne. Smells identical to Abercrombie & Fitch. Oh, wait, Abercrombie store called Fierce. It smells identical to that. The other one I picked up was a fall scent, and I was like, what the heck? What fall scent would I like? I don't really like the whole bakery type of scents. They kind of give me a headache. They're super strong, and I don't want my whole entire house to smell like a freaking bakery. So I went with Spice Cedar. Spice Cedar is a good alternative. It smells amazing. It smells really good. Hey, okay, sorry about that. So, I actually switched locations. My boyfriend came home and is all about Madden, so he's about to play a game, and I'm just like, it's going to be way too loud in here. So, where I just wanted to pick up where I left off really quickly.
Wallflowers.
There you go, the little wallflower plugins. I've had several of those already, but I just needed to buy some refills. So, they had a sale going on. You buy 6 for 24, so I went ahead and picked up a few of the ones from the Mahogany Teakwood as well, because when I light the candle, I'm going to go ahead and place these around the house as well, so the whole entire house can smell amazing. The other fragrances I picked up too was Fresh Cotton, because I always love the scent of Fresh Cotton, especially for bathrooms and bedrooms. Smells amazing. And the last one I picked up, a couple of scents were in the Eucalyptus Mint. I have that one in the bathroom right now, and I actually do like it. It smells super clean and really fresh, so I don't mind the scent at all. The last candle I have, that's so funny, watch that. The last candle I was meaning to show you was the Spice Cider. Spice Cider scent. To me, this is like my ideal of a fall scent. Called Brow Kit, and this one's in the color Arc Alert, number 12. Colors are amazing. I've been wearing this every single day. Super compact, has four separate colors. As you can see, it has a really pretty auburn color, which I like to use, as well as the dark brown to lighter brown and the taupe-ish blonde color, or taupe and blondish color, whatever. I do mix a lot of them all together. Actually, I've been doing like light in the front and going dark like midway and then kind of going back down. But I absolutely love this brow kit. It's super, super easy to put on. I did notice that they're not powder form. They're actually like a gel form, which is even cooler because while you're applying the color to your brows, it's actually helping with staying down, and you can kind of tame them very well with it as well. But I'm really liking that Sonia Kashuk, I guess it's called like a quad brow kit or what have you. So I love it. I picked up a few bracelets from Ross. And the first bracelet I have, if you follow me on Instagram, you've seen that I posted a picture of this. And if you don't, go ahead and check that out.
I picked up
was a Guess brand. And this is the, it's like there's like a lot of chain links. 1, 2, 3, 4, 5, 6. There's like 6 chain links attached to one clasp. To one clasp. So 6 of them. And it has a beautiful label that says Guess on it. I don't know if you can read that, but it says Guess. And I picked up that from Ross, as well as this gorgeous spiky bracelet. The spiky bracelet, it's like a pewter color. Both of them are like a pewter dark gray color, which I freaking love. My earrings are the same color as well, which I've had these forever. But the bracelet, I've been looking for a really cool spiky bracelet, and I think I found one. So I finally came across a spiky bracelet, but this one has spikes along with some rhinestone spikes, and I'm not sure if you can see that right there. Super cute. Love these two bracelets. She say she wanna take the skirt off. Be my guest. I decided to take my shirt off and show my chest. And we've been sipping on that Merlot, so you know what's next. Perfect in the mission, switching positions. We so. Anyhow, I want to say thank you everybody for watching. If you haven't subscribed, go ahead and subscribe now. And I will do my best to put out more videos. Let me see. Girl, I can't wait to get you home.